Hi everyone. So in this episode, we explore the text called Desiderata. This was shown to me many years ago when I was training in martial arts, and it was on the wall of the kwoon, and it really changed my life. So I'd love to share that with you now. I'll see you in the episode. So the big question is this: how do we live in more sustainable and regenerative ways? How can we tap into the ancient secrets of living in harmony with the sacred nature of life? How do we embody the interconnected web of life that thrives in abundance within each of us? That is the question, and this podcast will explore the answers. My name is Craig Hubbard, and welcome to Shambhala Living. Hi everyone, welcome back to the podcast. This episode, I'm going to share the Desiderata poem. This poem, if you haven't heard it, is a life-changing poem. When I first came across it, it was when I was training in martial arts as a black belt, and it was on the wall of the kwoon, and I would read it most nights that I was there training. I printed a copy of it and kept it in my notes, and I would read it often. This popped up back in my mind recently, and I found it and I read it, and it's still just as transformative now as it was then. I wanted to share that with you. I'm going to read it to you now, and I'll also paste a copy of it in the notes if you want to read it. I think it's a really transformative writing. So it goes like this. Desiderata. Go placidly amid the noise and haste, and remember what peace there may be in silence. As far as possible, without surrender, be on good terms with all persons. Speak your truth quietly and clearly, and listen to others. Even the dull and the ignorant, they too have their story. Avoid loud and aggressive persons. They are vexations to the spirit. If you compare yourself with others, you may become vain or bitter, for always there will be a greater or lesser person than yourself. Enjoy your achievements as well as your plans. Keep interested in your own career, however humble. It is a real possession in the changing fortunes of time. Exercise caution in your business affairs, for the world is full of trickery. But let this not blind you to what virtue there is. Many persons strive for high ideals, and everywhere life is full of heroism. Be yourself. Especially do not feign affection. Neither be cynical about love, for in the face of all aridity and disenchantment, it is as perennial as the grass. Take kindly the counsel of years, gracefully surrendering the things of youth. Nurture strength of spirit to shield you in sudden misfortune. But do not distress yourself with dark imaginings. Many fears are born of fatigue and loneliness. Beyond a wholesome discipline, be gentle with yourself. You are a child of the universe, no less than the trees and the stars. You have a right to be here. And whether or not it is clear to you, no doubt the universe is unfolding as it should. Therefore, be at peace with God, whatever you conceive Him to be. Whatever your labours and aspirations, in the noisy confusion of life, keep peace in your soul. With all its sham, drudgery, and broken dreams, it is still a beautiful world. Be cheerful, strive to be happy. And this is dated 1927 by Max Ehrman. So there's a little bit of a history about this, and there's some confusion over some dates. When I first read it, it was written that it was from 1692 and was found in the old St. Paul's Church. And it was written in 1927, but then Reverend Frederick Ward Cates was the church's rector, and from 1956 to 1961, and during that time he used the words of the Desiderata, and on the cover of the book he had the name and the date of Old St. Paul's Church, Baltimore, 1692, and those dates became linked. For a long time, it's been thought that that was when that was written, and I've seen some other attributions, but it's been widely known that it was written by Max Ehrman, and he also wrote a lot of other poems and poetry. He died in 1945, and that's the history of the Desiderata. And Desiderata means that which is desired. Yeah, I found that a really inspiring poem. If you want to listen again, then you could just re-listen to this, or you could read it in the show notes. So I hope you enjoyed that. I hope that the more you listen to it or the more you read that, that it has an effect or a transformation, something that you might get from that message. And I certainly did. Thanks for letting me share that with you. To me, that was a sacred poem. It really, as a teenager, it really changed my life. And I understand that it's changed a lot of people's lives. There's some really powerful sentences and words in there, and hopefully some of them stuck out to you. I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you in the next episode. Thanks for listening. Bye for now. Hey everyone, thank you so much for listening to this episode of the Shambhala Living Podcast. If you enjoyed it, then I'd love it if you would share it with some friends and subscribe to this channel and turn on notifications so you can find out when the next podcast comes out. You can find us at Instagram at Shambhala Farm, and also check out our upcoming 12-week food growing course. You can find out more details on our newsletter list or on Instagram. I'll see you on the next episode.